drink will flow and the blood will spill. And if the boys want to fight, you better let them.
I fight you, Rufus.
Hey, come on, let's go.
I'll have you, Sharpie.
No, come on.
Sharuf. Welcome to Sharuf. My name is John Sharpton.
I'm Rufus Bluestuff.
And we are honoured, excited, a little bit terrified, because our special guest today is comedian Tom O'Mahony.
Tom, how are you?
I'm good. How are you guys?
We're great.
We're just a little bit head up. That song gets me a bit aggro.
Yeah, it does a little bit.
Take it down a notch. I brought cookies.
Okay, cookies. In fairness.
Cookies.
Rufus, have you ever had a guest that brought us presents?
No! No, we haven't.
You know what? Jamie J. Carr.
Disgraceful.
Yeah,
Jamie. Oh, he's a good lad.
Jamie, he's a good lad.
Oh, yes, he brought a small child who beat me.
Oh, yeah.
Very generous of him.
But as well as that, he did bring a box of sweets as well.
Yeah, I suppose.
Tom, how was your Christmas?
I had a fantastic Christmas, as you well know.
As well I know, because ladies and gentlemen, Tom and myself were in a panto down in Limerick, and he played the illustrious role of Huntsman Pat. How was that for you?
We all know it kind of fitted me in fairly well.
Exactly.
It wasn't a big stretch, I'll be honest with you. It was just me stomping around the place with a giant axe.
Exactly.
That's essentially it.
So it's basically your Tuesday afternoon.
Yeah.
They paid you to go on stage.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
Now, Tom, tell us, you are a full-time comedian, is that
right? I'm a full-time stand-up comedian, yes.
How many people can actually say that, Rufus, that they are full-time comedians, especially in Ireland?
I think he's lying, to be quite frankly. I don't believe you.
As in, there's no way that you could make a living being a full-time comedian.
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
You come on this show, you just lie to our faces.
And to be honest, Tommy, you're kind of... Now, I don't mean to insult you, but you're a blow-in, for want of a better word, because you haven't done it for your whole life.
No, you had another profession.
And then you just did it one.
Right, so you're not a proper comedian who was telling jokes from the moment they were born.
No, and I have very little angst. I am okay with myself.
Wow.
I just enjoy having the crack with people from a stage to their ears.
So. No, I definitely don't believe you.
Yeah. No, I wasn't always. No, I was never arty, really. I suppose I was probably very chatty, as most Irish people are.
Absolutely.
But I worked in construction right up until the point that I took up comedy and said, all right, I want to give this thing a go.
Would that have been around 2008 by any chance?
Thereabouts.
Well,
yeah.
I don't know how I knew that.
It's funny how going from actually not having a job to something else makes you a full-time at that thing. Isn't it?
I actually thought, wow, how did Rufus possibly know that? Like, when I was getting things ready, were you two chatting or something like that?
No. I just have the power to remember things.
He has his finger on the economic pulse of Ireland.
Exactly.
And he was also in construction as well, if I remember correctly.
I was. Well, you know, I have a degree in electrical engineering.
Is that what happened to his hair?
Yeah, that's it.
And he used to be human. No, he's joking. So, Rufus, when you were in New York, right, and you were working construction there on a planet called New York, let me hear your wolf whistle.
Sharpie, I would never do such a thing.
Very good.
How modern of you. I knew what you were like back in 2007. You were absolutely wolf whistling everywhere.
Now, I would never use this, but listen.
Oh, you flipped!
Stop!
That got me going.
Now, Tom, I have a question for you.
Yes.
It's a new year.
Uh-huh.
It's 2019.
Yes.
Because 2018 is over.
Yeah.
And you're going to be able to answer this as a comedian.
Yeah.
Can we slag each other again?
Absolutely.
Yes!
110%.
It's over, guys. We've done it.
Sharpie, yeah. You're terrible.
Why?
I thought we just...
Oh, because we're slagging each other. Yeah. Shut your mouth, Rufus, you old dope.
He's very literal, isn't he?
Oh, he just goes straight.
Yeah, just you're terrible. Yeah. Yeah, there's no lead in, like, you know, at your new haircut or anything like that. He's just straight in telling you you're terrible.
I called it like I see them.
Yeah, and when you did Cherry Comedy for the first time, you just got up and started calling people terrible. It didn't go well, sure didn't.
I got the reaction I wanted. I don't know what they were expecting.
He's darker than I thought.
Rufus is darker.
You thought I was a light blue then?
Yeah, there you go.
Now, Tom, have you been busy since Panto finished?
I have indeed. This is New Year for the podcast, which you have been on.
I have indeed.
So yeah, it's just been busy just rolling in guests basically for the next couple of months. Buying new gear, cameras and stuff like that, because typically I record live from the Laughter Lounge on Eden Quay in Dublin, but now we're going to be streaming it live.
Really?
In the next couple of weeks we're going to be streaming live.
The podcast?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah,
wow, brilliant.
So some fun, interesting guests and whatnot, and I've just been gigging because there was a backlog. There was like a 6 weeks where we were rehearsing and we were on stage, and there was just a bunch of gigs kind of building up, and it looks like I'm going to be going to Singapore.
Wow!
I know.
For a
couple of gigs, yeah.
Wow.
There's a company called LA Comedy. I don't know why they call themselves LA. They're in nowhere near LA.
Maybe for Lower Asia.
Well done!
Rufus Bluestuff, you're on the ball, man.
I'm feeling very smart today. I should probably come with you as your translator.
Why not? Actually, how's your Singaporean?
No, not at all, huh?
Oh my god!
Wow, better than mine.
I have no idea. I just made that up.
Definitely insulted somebody.
Imagine
you being
insulted someone so badly. Like,
that'd be amazing if you actually had insulted someone.
Sharuf fan in Singapore. Like, oh no, not the Singapore American. Tom, that's amazing though. They're bringing you off in Singapore.
Yeah.
Unreal.
So they want to hear some Irish comedy in Singapore.
Unreal.
They speak Irish in Singapore. That's impressive.
It's a far-reaching area of the Gaeltacht. On Singapore.
On Singapore.
Singapore.
Now, Tom, just going back to the podcast and stuff.
Yes.
If someone was to ask me, what's Tom O'Mahony's podcast about? I would literally, now, and you can correct me if I'm wrong here, but I would say it's just a collection of Irish people talking to funny man Tom O'Mahony from all walks of life. And overall, you're going to get a real feel for what it is to be Irish. It's a pure Irishism thing. Now, maybe you've had a lot of...
No, you're spot on. You're actually nailed it on the head. And I didn't think it was going to be that. It was just people that I found interesting, from lads like yourself to sports people to actors and comedians and stuff. But it turns out the messages I get from people who are living abroad, they've really expressed that they can't believe, and they're so jealous almost of the level of identity that we have and the pride in our identity. And I was like, oh yeah, it turns out we kind of are, I suppose.
That's awesome though.
So
it's literally what you have an interest in. So let's say sports or comedy and stuff, and people within that field, you go, do you know what, he'd be great on the podcast.
Yeah.
And you just get them all, and it's brilliant. Like, I just throw in the headphones, bring the dog for a walk in the park for an hour, and I just sit there chuckling. I look like a crazy person because I'm walking around hitting the ball with a hurley for the dog, and I'm just laughing away at what I'm hearing. Like, it's brilliant.
So you do look like yourself, typically, just crazy.
Except when there's headphones in people.
How did you get the headphones into the dog's ears as well?
Django loves...
Yeah, really?
He's a remarkably erudite dog.
I knew... He's on my Patreon, actually. That's right. Fairness to him. Yeah, he's getting all the bonus content. By the way, if anybody does listen to it, and they do go on to Patreon, there's a ton of bonus content from... a podcast to myself and Jerry McBride. Did you ever meet Jerry McBride?
I've never met him, but I've heard of him.
One of the writers, the chief writers of Waterford Whispers News.
Wow. Okay.
So Waterford Whispers, for those, it's kind of like The Onion, I think, in America. Would that be right, really?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, that's pretty much exactly it.
Right, so it's Waterford Whispers, but it's all Irish headlines and stuff, and it's spoofs, so it's really, really funny stuff. And also, a lot of our audience is from America and other parts of the world outside Ireland. So we know that you're here because you love the Irish humour and the wit and the crack that we have.
Don't touch me.
So we'll leave links to all platforms where you can find Tom's podcast. I really think you'll enjoy it. It's called Buckshot as well. And it's doing really well.
Yeah, it's doing good. Thank you very much to everybody who is or who is going to be a listener.
Yes.
I didn't realise I was going to enjoy it this much, but it's actually really good.
You're having a ball of time.
It's a great crack.
That's awesome. Now, can I ask you about a touring show that you are doing around Scotland, is that right?
It's going to be, it's going to be around Ireland.
Oh,
so
right,
this, yeah, so it's now been bought by, it's called Defending the Caveman.
Yeah.
It is the longest running show in Broadway, longest running one person show in Broadway and Vegas history. It still runs in both places.
Wow.
And now it's going to tour Ireland, and I think I may be touring Scotland with it as well, but that won't kick off until the autumn.
Brilliant. So when I was asking you a question, I was like, maybe I'm not allowed to talk about this.
No, it's this right as of now, I can totally talk about
brilliant.
It. Yeah, because it wasn't up until the panto at the finish, and now promotions will go into that now at the minute. So it's
excellent.
Yeah, fantastic.
So you can follow Tom on Instagram and Twitter as well, and follow his update with the touring one-man show called Defending the Caveman. Excellent. Rufus, will you check it out?
Yeah, absolutely. Yes,
yeah.
I'm a huge fan of the Digital Theatre.
He's absolutely not going to. And
you will never see me again.
No, I know. That's how professional he is. He's actually dealing with me. That's all he's doing. It's just putting up with me. Isn't that right, Rufus?
I endure you, sir. No, I love you. I love you.
He's a good guy.
He's a good lad.
Even if he isn't, I'm enjoying his company.
Yeah. Yeah. As a presenter on this show, I kind of, I'll be like, oh, that's fantastic. And Rufus will pipe in and say, no, it's not. That's boring what you're talking about.
Sharpie asked me to be nicer to the guests.
Yeah. No, I don't want niceness. No, I want genuine, deep, honest meanness. Because you know what you're dealing with a mean person, don't
Sharpie,
you?
Sharpie, I like this guy.
Yeah, you too. I knew you two would actually get
I feel
right.
like he's encouraging me to live my best life.
Hashtag living
the
my best life.
Version of yourself, exactly. Now, Tom, on Sharuf, we can't let you go without doing a challenge. So what we've done is, and I'm actually really glad you're here because we can showcase this. I got this thing from Wish.com for like a fiver. Wish.com. There's a discount. They just gave me.
You have no shame, dude. No shame.
Wow. Oh my god. Other than just tattooing it on his forehead.
It's just artistic integrity. Wow. Gone. Where is it? Out the window. There it goes.
Sneak it in there. Oh my
god. Anyway, I got this thing called an Easy Cap, which lets you play your old retro games through your laptop. Now, there's a bit of a green line on the side of it. I don't know. I'll hopefully be able to edit that out.
It's just because we're Irish. We're patriots. That's right.
Yeah, because we love it. So we are going to play a game called Killer Instinct on the Super Nintendo because, among other things, in the past, we did a lot of fighting. We had a little fight club. It was pretty awesome.
Oh yeah.
We did our
a lot of people died.
A lot of people got hurt.
There used to be 7 dwarves in that panto.
And then it was down to 3.
Down to 3.
The 3 winners. And then as well as that, we played Street Fighter in our house, and we played a lot of card games as well. So we are going to play Killer Instinct on the Super Nintendo. I will throw you this because I know you're a good fighter, because you bet me in fight club in about 13 seconds flat. So here we go.
I think it was closer to 9.
Yeah.
But look, I'm not counting.
I was trying to do myself a favour. Well, I'm going to turn on the sound. There we go.
Okay, so this is Killer Instinct, is it?
This is Killer Instinct.
Who makes this?
This is Rare Software.
Is it? There we go. All right. Okay.
And yeah, this looks like some black market stuff. Are you sure it should be allowed to play this?
It was actually banned. This is an
old. It's called Killer Instinct. What do they think?
Yeah,
they're not even coming in soft. They're just going, let's call it Killer Instinct.
Isn't it so funny? Because it actually looks like it was created using a potato. Like you can't really. It's very pixelated because it's an old retro game. Like so, but it was over 18s just because of the sheer violence.
Am I Jago?
You're Jago, yeah, man.
Do I get a choice or no? Is it just how are you changing those? All right.
Yeah.
Okay.
You know what's really depressing, Sharp?
What?
When you play this game again, like we used to play it as you're a kid. And you're playing again, and you're reading the bios of all the fighters, and you realize they're all younger than you.
Oh God!
Oh, really?
Yeah, they're all like in their early 20s.
No way.
And in unbelievably good condition.
In seriousness.
You've got a giant lizard.
Yeah,
man.
I'm Riptor.
Oh, you know, Riptor, all right.
You know why they call him Riptor?
He's on steroids.
Because he got. So is Jago. Look at him.
Yeah, Jago, in fairness, is definitely juicing.
He's 14.
He is definitely. Yeah, he's juicing. But you know what? I paid to see him fight.
Yeah, exactly.
You've got a tail. That's not. I have a sword on my back and I can't take it off.
It's just there's something else to grab onto.
Okay.
Rufus.
Ooh,
okay.
For a fighting hold. I mean, what are you talking about?
No, yeah.
Totally.
But I'm just wondering, I've got a sword on my back. How am I not bringing that to the fight?
It's the usual thing. There's special moves that you press up, down, B, hold R for 5 seconds.
Say all that again.
Exactly. And then you might take the sword
out
for 1 second.
You've got blue blood, as it turns out. Royalty. Yeah. You've got blue blood.
Again, because of this easy cap.
You talking to me?
Yeah, Rufus.
I don't have blood. My anatomy is weird, man.
Okay,
I've got no bones.
Oh my god.
Yeah, I've got no bones, I've got no blood. It's weird.
It is a bit weird.
Oh yes! Up you go, right in the nose. I finished him off by kicking him in the nose.
Right, well, we're not playing this anymore.
Oh,
so
gee.
Once again.
Oh my god. So did you get beaten at your own game?
It happens more often than you think.
I thought you were into this.
Terrible.
I'm so excited. I haven't played a computer game in about 14 years.
Well, you keep that.
Actually, the only time I think he's ever beaten someone at a computer game on the show was when we had a professional computer game player on.
Who was that?
That was Sally Rage.
Oh, yeah.
You did beat Sally Rage.
Boom. Yeah, I bet Sally Rage at Pac-Man.
So it's like he was so bad that none of her fancy tactics would work on him.
How ironic.
I know.
How ironical.
It's like the hunter had become the hunted.
That's exactly what it was like. Now, Tom, before we let you go, have you any hellos for anyone? Have you anything you'd like to shamelessly plug? Because that's what we're all about right here on Sharuf. Or have you anything you'd like to ask us?
Do you know what?
None of the above.
None of the above, actually. I'm just glad for the only thing really that I'm doing out there publicly, other than actually performing in stand-up comedy clubs and stuff, is the podcast. Now we'll be going, there'll even be more layers on. I'm going to be doing about 3 or 4 podcasts a week by the middle of the year. So like that, if you're into podcasts,
you hear that, Sharpie? That's called a work ethic.
Right, cool.
Look it up.
Yeah, it happens when you get married, Rufus. It happens. You have no choice but to actually just get out of the house and work.
And make some money.
And make some money.
Make dollar. Brilliant. Well, listen, as I said, we're going to put links to everything that you're working on down below. Please do like, follow, and subscribe to what Tom is offering, because it's actually really, really funny content, and I can vouch for it because I'm mad at myself. Ladies and gentlemen, that is all we have time for. Before I say goodbye, I would like to formally thank Mr. Tom O'Mahony. Thank you so much for coming, man.
Oh, pleasure, it's been a pleasure.
Pleasure. We will see you right here on Patreon and YouTube on Sharuf.